And then, like, every time we go to Publix, it's always rotten fruit. You know what I mean? Dang.
All right, today we're checking out John Mellencamp. We're listening to the song Rain on the Scarecrow. Let's get into it.
Well, all the government wants to talk about, they want to keep giving more loans and more loans. That's all. Seems like that's all they've got in their head. We don't need another loan. We need a good price. Just another farm loan, that's just another payment we got to make, and we can't afford to do that.
I think the politicians are playing games with us, you know. It don't cost them anything to change the rule, you know, on embargo in another country.
Well, they want us cheap food, which I can see that, but they don't take the farmer into consideration at all.
Just sick of working 10 or 12 hours a day or more and just breaking even if you're lucky, if you're real good. If I had to start all over, if I knew what I was going to be like when I got out of high school, I probably wouldn't have done it.
You want to buy a farm?
Problems today.
Like, yeah.
The same problems. Probably much worse.
Yeah. Wasn't there just a trade war a few years back that affected farmers?
I think so. I don't know. But when I built that website for that farm people, like the farm company, it was just like, dang, like all the injuries and accidents and the cost of insurance and the cost to like work the land and then the amount that you can actually produce. And then they like, you know, everything's all chemical and, you know, super factory produced modern day. It's like,
yeah, I mean, the government does a lot of weird stuff that affects a lot of industries.
Yeah.
Don't they do weird, like, sugar subsidies? And didn't they get sued by Brazil? Now they have to subsidize a sugar grown in Brazil and just, I don't know, a bunch of weird stuff. And don't they pay some people not to grow crops?
Yeah, yeah.
So the price don't get too low. And just, I don't know how all that stuff works. But I'm quite sure these guys have legitimate grievances with the government.
It's so weird to think about. Like, what if literally America had no farming? Like, no independent farms?
And we'd be eating all lab-grown food or imported food. That was grown with chemicals and GMO. That might be what they want.
True. Fake meat. Let's dig it in. We can't work with steers and cows. Blood on the scarecrow. Blood on the plow. Blood on the scarecrow.
Crosses planted in the courthouse yard. 97 families who lost 97 farms. I think about my grandpa, my neighbors, and my name. Some nights I feel like dying, like a scarecrow in the rain. Blood on the plow, the land for the nation. Every slant made me proud. Son, I'm just sorry, there's just memories for you now.
I can't even, like, process the concept of being, like, inheriting a farm.
Right.
You know what I mean? I feel like farm life, like, it's, like, it's just, like, this thing I've seen on TV and then, like, read about, and, you know, but it's, like, I can't imagine, like, actually farming.
I want to know what the government was doing back then that affected farmers. I mean, government's always doing something. It's, like, the free market is heavily regulated and the government does a lot of weird stuff.
Yeah.
Like, it's free in the sense of, like, yeah, you could bring a product to the market. There's a lot of red tape. There's subsidies for some industries. This is not, I don't know how all that works. But there's a lot of rules, a lot of regulations.
Taxes, like, extra taxes. It's like, dang.
Yeah.
Like, I remember, okay, this is vague because, I mean, it was 3-4 years ago when I made this website. But it was like a farmer, like an average farmer makes like 50 grand.
Dang.
After all that effort, liability.
And they ain't working 8-hour days.
Yeah, very expensive equipment and stuff like that. But it was just like, it wasn't like a lot of money. And then it was like 50% of like farm deaths or like injuries related to equipment or something. It was just crazy.
Blood on the plow.
Yeah, it's just like, whoa, like the risk farmers take so we can have actual food. And then like every time we go to Publix, it's always rotten fruit. You know what I'm saying? It's like, no, it's dang, not. The risk people are taking no, out there not. So we can eat good. And then we end up eating chemicals anyway. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I just want to know what happened. But I guess he grew up on a farm then. Well, that's John Mellencamp's origin story. Grew up on a farm, and then they had to, well, got auctioned off, foreclosed on.
Dang. Yeah, all that acreage, oh my gosh. Can you imagine how expensive it is? Like, how much they charge just for the, I don't know, I imagine there's taxes on the land or something, right?
Yeah. Probably so, personal property tax.
What if it's like 400 acres, and then you get like, let's say you produce like one crop in one season of the year. How in the world do you pay for that? Like, year after year after year?
Government gives you a loan. I don't know. I'm saying the government's probably doing something to keep the prices of food low. And so they can't make a living.
For who? For, oh, like for,
well,
like,
they're importing, like, tons of food from all the other places, and the farmers are competing with that. So that's going to drive the price down, supply and demand.
Yeah.
So they're importing a ton of supply. Maybe something to that effect. I don't know. But whenever something has a grievance with the government, I lean towards the person because the government does a lot of shady stuff. And then maybe the person's wrong. Maybe the government's right. Maybe not. Probably not. I just have an inherent distrust for the government. I do. Yeah. It is what it is.
I don't know. Tell me, man, what do you know?
What do you know?
Me and my boys on the road. I see the goal. She told me, boy, you the goal. Like, I don't know. But I don't know.